Large organizations with multiple customer bases often use multiple business units to manage their marketing data set and campaigns. The parent business unit, on the other hand, manages centralized reporting and marketing templates to be propagated across all the child business units. With this release, the marketing app now supports all this across various aspects of marketing execution. For example, differentiated contact access, segment members, contact insights, and assets like email templates. Let's see this with an example. So in this example, we have got two different persona from two different business units. So here I've got David from insurance, and he has a segment for all the folks from New York. On the other browser, I've got John from mortgage, who has exact same definition for all the folks from New York. However, their member set is totally different. Here I see David and Sadie as the members, while in the other business units, I only see Angela as the member. So it just shows that even though the segmentation is definition is same, it's running in the context of their individual business units. Similarly, if I look at the emails, here I've got insurance-related emails, even though they reside on the same instance, it's for the insurance business unit. On the other hand, on the mortgage business unit, I see the digital transformation event registration assets. Similarly, if I flip to the leads, I see David Lee here has got interaction related to the mortgage industry and event attendance. And if I move to the insurance business unit, Cecilia here has the insurance summit. It just proves that each of the business units have their own view of the marketing assets, segmentation, and lead scoring, even though they are part of the same organization. So we observed how business units can run their end-to-end marketing independent of each other, even though parent business units can have a centralized view of all the marketing activity. Marketers need to define target segments for their campaigns. In this release, we have created an improved experience for creating powerful logic that helps with precise selection of contacts that you want to target. Most commonly used segments based on demographic and firmographic details, interaction records, are on the segmentation splash screen. This helps you get started easily and gradually move on to advanced scenarios. The new experience even lets you work across related entities to establish wide-ranging selection criteria. Now let's see how this works. So Verenika is now trying to build a new segment. She lands into a splash screen, which helps her build most commonly used segments. For example, demographic based on the personal information of the contacts in the database, or firmographic, which is based on the companies that your contacts belong to, for example, their size or industry. Or it could be behavioral, like their web visits, clicks, emails open. You could even manually select the contacts that you want to add to your segment, or you could combine existing segments together, for example, contacts that are in New York, but not in a newsletter segment. Now, all of these help her get started quickly. Now, let's try to build one segment. Verenika can provide a name to the segment. She can add attributes from the contact, like, for example, which company the segment belongs to. She can add more complex logic, combining multiple such groups of contacts to yield a single segment. Let's have a quick look on different types of segment. Now, this one is a simple demographic segment based on city, that is on the contact records, and looking if it was created within last few days. This one is a more complex segment, which is based on a different rated entity originating with leads. It's looking at all the leads who are either hot or warm, and they were generated this year. And this would be the target for the campaign Verenika wants to run. Now let's see a compound segment. Now this is a combination of different type of segments. For example, members from different regions, but I'm combining with a imported data segment from a third-party source together and targeting very precisely. Verunica can see this visually, how these different segments are getting combined to yield the results that she really wanted. So we observed how marketers can easily create segments without needing to lean on their IT teams and yet leverage the power of underlying Dynamics 365 data as well as behavioral data. Customer journeys pass through many states while you create, edit, and run them. Often it's not clear to users when they would start sending out emails, and this can make any marketer very, very nervous. You can now view a full history of these milestones for any customer journey. This provides a clear visibility into when they would start executing and if they did indeed start as expected. Now let's get into a quick demo. So Verunica is a marketer who has just launched her Contoso Chairs campaign. And as she clicks into the campaign to see how it's doing, she can see the milestones. And from the milestone, it's clear that the journey, when the journey was created, when it got published, and the fact that it has actually started. Now, this gives a very clear feedback to Verunica. So now let's look on another journey, digital transformation journey with Verunica is running. Now, we had heard this feedback that many times journeys don't start in time, or at least users feel that they did not start in time. Now, with this clear milestone, we can observe that even when the journey started, but it had a delayed start, the system gives you a feedback that, yes, it did start, but it had some delay. In some extreme scenarios, the journey may not even have started, and this also comes back as a very clear feedback that the journey is not yet started, and it has already been delayed by 43 minutes.